Hello everyone, today we will be trying to explain to you the procedure of capping of concrete core. It is done to ensure that both the ends of a concrete cylinder core have smooth, uniform bearing surfaces which are parallel to each other and also perpendicular to the applied load. If the ends of a concrete core are undulated as shown in this figure, of course this is an exaggerated view, then on application of load using the bearing plate on both ends, the load which is supposed to be applied as uniform load on both the ends is converted into a series of point loads. This causes the concrete cylinder to crack in an irregular manner and thus you obtain erroneous results. Capping of concrete is done to ensure a smooth bearing surface so that this applied load is converted into a properly uniformly distributed load so that we get the perfect test results for the strength of the concrete cylinder. Capping also ensures that both the ends of the concrete specimen are perfectly perpendicular to the applied loads.
Common methods and materials which are used for the capping of the concrete is explained in IS 516-1959. And the most common methods which are used for the capping of concrete are bonded sulfur capping or gypsum capping. And otherwise we can use unbonded capping by using neoprene parts. So today we are going to do the capping of the concrete by method of bonded sulfur capping. We will go to the experiment now.
Amorphous sulfur, apparatus for holding the cylinder in place. This is the apparatus for heating. These are the concrete cores that we are going to test. As you can clearly see, there are a few undulations on these surfaces against which we provide the necessary sulfur capping. So first of all, we take out the sulfur into the container, remove any lumps if there are any. Then we start heating the sulfur. We have to heat the sulfur till it becomes liquid and workable. Keep checking the sulfur after every few minutes. And we have to take necessary safety precautions like a mask because the fumes of the sulfur are dangerous to health. When the sulfur becomes liquid, we may oil the mold and pour a little quantity of this molten sulfur into that mold. Before it solidifies, we carefully place the cylinder into the molten sulfur. The apparatus makes sure that this cylinder is held in a perfectly upright manner throughout this process. Within a few seconds, the sulfur solidifies. We may remove the cylinder by gently tapping on the mold as shown. The surface so obtained is far smoother and uniform than the initial sample. We shall repeat a similar procedure for the other end of the core specimen. After leaving the cylinder for 2 hours for attaining sufficient strength, this is the cylinder that we obtain, which is properly capped. This can be directly used for compression testing. This is the compression testing of the cylinder after its capping. After properly placing the cylindrical sample, we turn on the compression testing machine. The machine loads the sample at a uniformly increasing load till its failure. Capping eliminates the stress concentration on both the ends of the cylinder, and thus we get the proper results for this compression testing.